And time now at 6:50, the 2010-2011 school year underway in less than just 5 weeks, getting the kids ready to go back to school is our parenting pipeline this morning. Joining me, Maria Bailey, author of Ultimate Mom and Mom Talk Radio. Thank you for being here, Maria.
Thanks, Kara.
You are very welcome. Let's get right to it. A recent study shows parents plan to cut back this year on clothing and supplies. How can moms and dads get the best bang for their buck?
Well, believe it or not, starting early can save you money. Even now, the other day I was in a retailer, and there's lots of buy one, get one free sales that have started on school supplies. Now's the time to buy. Buy in bulk so that you have them long term. And don't forget, pens, pencils, notebook paper, they run out throughout the year. So now, while the stores are having them at such rock bottom prices, stock up now because you'll be happy you did in November.
How can parents give back to schools as they cut back?
Well, one of the things is you're going to have to purchase something, whether it's pens, notebooks, and a lot of retailers now give anywhere between 2 and 10% back to the school. So make sure when you get to the register that you give the cashier the name of your school so that you can give back while you're purchasing at that retailer.
When it comes to clothing and school supplies, how much should parents anticipate spending?
I hate to say this. The good news is it's down from last year. Last year, the average parent spent about $570. This year, it's anticipated about $440 per child.
Wow. What about using things like consignment shops or eBay to find better deals on things like clothing?
It's a great idea, particularly if your children aren't wearing uniforms, because you can always find the leading brands at a discounted price.
Now, according to a recent study, while parents are spending less, they're actually volunteering more. How can parents do this?
Well, that's a good thing, because as budgets are being cut back for the schools, the schools need more. So it's a lot of offices are now open at the schools. Give the school a call and see, is there something on the teacher's wish list? You might have an extra DVD player laying around the house or an old chemistry set that hasn't been touched. And you can also volunteer your time as they're cutting back special teachers. Maybe you step in and help do the bulletin boards in the hallways or such. There's lots you can do in volunteering.
In our local school system, how much of a need is there for that? I know you have kids in the school system. What are you seeing?
You know, 30% of all teachers contribute their own paychecks towards supplies in the classroom. So there is a huge need in both Broward, Dade, Palm Beach, all over South Florida. So, you know, when you're meeting that teacher, ask them, is there something extra you need for your class? And you, again, may have it lying around your house, or you may be able to pick it up when you're out shopping.
Awesome, Maria Bailey. Thank you so much for giving us great advice for sending the kids back to school, which is just around the corner.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Maria.
Thank you.